Very good morning, my dear students. I welcome you all once again for VTU e-Shikshana program. Myself, Dr. Madhukeshwara N., Professor of Mechanical Engineering Department, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. Today, I am going to continue the next session, that is actually the fifth session on thermal radiation chapter of heat transfer subject. In the previous sessions, we have covered the topics on basic theory of radiation, concept of electromagnetic wave spectrum, radiation properties of surfaces, concept of different bodies such as black body, white body, gray body, opaque body and transparent body, spectral and emissive power, Stefan-Boltzmann law and constant, Kirchhoff's law, Planck's law, Wien's displacement law, gray body and emissive power of the gray body, some solved examples also we have done. Along with this, we have also covered solid angle and intensity of radiation, Lambert's cosine law, radiosity, net energy leaving a surface, wave factor, net exchange between surfaces, electrical analogy for radiation and some examples. Again, we have also covered radiation heat exchange between two infinite black surfaces and radiation heat exchange between two infinite parallel gray surfaces. Today, we will continue some more concepts on the radiation heat transfer. So one of the important topic on radiation heat transfer is radiation shield. So radiation shield is nothing but it is a place in front of the radiating surface to reduce the heat radiation. Generally, it shields the radiating surface. The shields are used for reducing the heat transfer from one plane to another plane. Let plane 3 be placed in between two plates 1 and 2 as shown in the figure 21. See, this is the radiation shield between two plates. This is the plane 3. That is a shield placed between the surface or plates 1 and 2 as shown in the figure below. Let the plates be at a temperature T1, T2, T3. See, here there are three plates considered. T1, T2 and T3 are the temperature of these three plates, 1, 2 and 3 respectively. Whereas the plane 3 is in between plane 1 and 2 and it acts as a radiation shield. Now, as per the derivation, we have derived the last class, that is radiation energy between two infinite parallel gray surfaces, that is Q1 to 3 can be written as between these two surfaces 1 and 3, that is equal to area into sigma Stefan-Boltzmann constant into temperature of these two are to be considered T1 to the power of 4 minus the temperature of the surface 3 is T3 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 divided by emissivity of the surface 1 epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by emissivity of the surface 3 epsilon 3 minus 1. Similarly, using the same derivation or equation which we have derived in the last class, I can write the equation for the surface 3 and 2, that is Q3 to 2, that is the radiation heat transfer from 3 to 2 is equal to area of the surface into Stefan-Boltzmann constant sigma multiplied by T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4. Where T3 and T2 are temperatures of surface 3 and surface 2 respectively, whole divided by 1 divided by epsilon 33 plus epsilon 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1, whereas epsilon 3 and epsilon 2 are emissivities of surface 3 and surface 2 respectively. Now for steady state condition, Q1 to 3 is equal to Q3 to 2, means for steady state the radiation heat transfer from 1 to 3 is equal to the radiation heat transfer from 3 to 2. Therefore, equating the above two equations, so we can get A into sigma is common in both the equations, we can cancel out, and remaining terms we have written T1 minus T3 to the power of 4, this is also T1 to the power of 4, whole divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1, which is equal to this term excluding A into sigma because it has cancelled, T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 minus epsilon 2, 1 divided by epsilon 2 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1. If emissivities are considered as equal for all the surfaces or planes 1, 2, 3, epsilon 1 is equal to epsilon 2 is equal to epsilon 3, then simplifying we will get T3 to the power of 4 is equal to half of T1 to the power of 4 plus T2 to the power of 4. Now substituting the above value of T3 to the power of 4 in the equation of Q1 to 3, we will get A sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus this value is nothing but T3 to the power of 4 which we have derived in the last slide. That is nothing but half into T1 to the power of 4 plus T2 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1, which is equal to half into A into sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1. Now, if there is no shield, then Q1 to 2 is, means if we remove the in between plate 3, then we can write Q1 to 2 as A into sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1. Now again, we have already considered epsilon 1 is equal to epsilon 2 is equal to epsilon 3. Then Q1 to 3, that is this equation, can be simplified as half into A into sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4. See, these two terms are added, therefore it will become 2 divided by epsilon minus 1. And this equation will become Q1 to 2 is equal to half into A sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 2 divided by epsilon minus 1. From the above two equation, we see that Q1 to 3 with shield is equal to half of the Q1 to 2. So this is what we can derive from the radiation shield. Now, let us take a problem on the concept of radiation. That is, a pipe carrying steam having an outer diameter of 20 cm runs in a large room and is exposed to air at a temperature of 30 degrees centigrade. The pipe surface temperature is 400 degrees centigrade. calculate the loss of heat due to surroundings per meter length of the pipe due to thermal radiation. If the emissivity of the pipe surface is 0.8, what would be the loss of heat due to radiation if pipe is enclosed in a 40 centimeter diameter brick and conduct the emissivity 0.91. So now here there is a pipe which carries a steam which is having an outer diameter 20 centimeter in a large room exposed to the air. Air temperature is 30 degree centigrade. The pipe surface temperature is 400 degree centigrade. So we have to calculate the loss of the heat to the surrounding per meter length of the pipe due to the radiation. If the emissivity of the surface is 0.8, what we have considered. So again, what would be the loss due to the radiation if the pipe is enclosed in a 40 centimeter brick, so which conducts or radiates with an emissivity of 0.91. Now, so we can determine Q2 is equal to sigma A1 epsilon 1 T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4. So for the first condition, when the pipe is exposed to the air, so we can determine what is the loss of the heat. So for that, sigma value 5.657 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into area, that is the surface area, pi d into L, pi c, diameter is 20 centimeter, 20 divided by 100 means 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter into L. L is per unit length we have considered, therefore it is 1. So this is pi d L, surface area per unit length, multiplied by epsilon. Epsilon is for initially the surface is having an emissivity of 0.8 we have considered. T1 is surface temperature 400 to the power of 400 divided by 2 plus 273 to the power of 4 in order to convert it into the Kelvin, minus T2 to the power of 4. So here T2 is 30 degree centigrade plus 273 to the power of 4. Now here after the simplification, 5.657 into 10 to the power of minus 8 pi into 20 centimeter, that is 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into 0.8, this will become 673 divided by 100 to the power of 4 minus 303 divided by 100 to the power of 4. So which is nothing but 5594 watts. Now, when it is enclosed in a brick which conducts heat, which is having a 40 centimeter diameter, we can write the equation as the heat lost is nothing but sigma into A1 into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus A1 by A2 into 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1. Again, substituting the values of sigma 5.657 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into pi, this is a diameter 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 or 20 divided by 100 meter into T1 673 to the power of 4 minus T2 303 to the power of 4 in Kelvin, 1 divided by epsilon 1, that is 1 by 0.8, that is a initially the emissivity of the pipe, plus 20 by 40 is the ratio of A1 to A2 into 1 minus epsilon 2. Epsilon 2 is the emissivity of this brick, so 0.91 brick wall, so minus 1. So after simplification, finally we will get 5381 watts when it is enclosed by a brick wall So it will lose us a heat of 5381 watts. So let us take one more problem. Here, two parallel plates are at a temperature 400 degrees Celsius and 200 degrees Celsius. Both the plates are having an emissivity of 0.8. Another plate with an emissivity of 0.9 is interposed between the two plates. Determine the percentage change in the rate of radiation heat transfer. So there are two plates, 1 and 2 initially, which are at 400 degrees Celsius and 200 degrees Celsius. When it is converted into Kelvin, 673 Kelvin and 473 Kelvin. And one more plate is plate number 3 is interposed, means kept in between these two plates. So 1 and 2 having the emissivity 0.8 and 0.8, whereas 3 is having the emissivity of 0.9. So we have to determine the percentage change of rate of radiation heat transfer. So to find out this one, that is radiation between T1 and T2 without shield, we have to first calculate. So that is Q2 is equal to sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. That is, this is nothing but Q, radiation heat transfer from 1 to 2 without shield. So substituting sigma Stefan Boltzmann constant 5.657 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 673 to the power of 4 minus 473 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by 0.8 plus 1 divided by 0.8 minus 1, which is nothing but 5848.96 watt. So this is radiation heat transfer from the plate 1 to plate 2 without shield. Now with shield, when we consider, so that we will derive in the next section. Now equating with shield T1, the heat transfer from 1 to 3 and 3 to 2, we will get T1 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1, which is equal to T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 divided by epsilon 3 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1. In these two equations, since the areas and the Stefan Boltzmann constant sigma are constant, they are cancelled. And in these two equations, simplifying these two equations by substituting the values of emissivity, we can write T1 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 divided by 0.8 plus 1 divided by 0.9 minus 1. That is, epsilon 1 is 0.8, epsilon 3 is 0.9. Epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 both are same. Therefore, T2 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 divided by 0.9 plus 1 divided by 0.8 minus 1. Now also you can see epsilon 3 is 0.9, epsilon 2 is 0.8. After simplification, you can cancel the denominator. Finally, you will get T1 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 is equal to T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4. Now, T3 is equal to T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole divided by 2 to the power of 1 by 4. We know the values of T1 and T2 temperatures. Substituting 673 to the power of 4 plus 473 to the power of 4 whole divided by 2 whole square to the power of 1 by 4 is equal to 597.67 degree Kelvin. That is the temperature, surface temperature of the intermediate or in between the plate, that is plate 3. Now we can find out the radiation heat transfer with shield. Therefore, which is equal to sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1. So area is taken as 1 meter square, therefore which is equal to 5.657 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into area is here we have taken as 1 meter square per meter square into 673 to the power of 4, that is nothing but T1 given in the problem, plus 597.67 to the power of 4, that is the temperature of the intermediate plate to the power of 4, whole divided by 1 divided by 0.8, that is emissivity of the plate 1, 1 divided by 0.9, that is emissivity of the plate 3 minus 1. After calculation, we will get heat transfer with the shield as 3225.57 Watt. Now then we can find out the percentage reduction. So initially from 1 to 2 the radiation heat transfer is 5848.98, means without shield. So that is the total radiation. That minus of with shield is 3225.57 divided by again the maximum radiation from 1 to 2, 5848.96. So if we do this, we will get the percentage reduction in the radiation heat transfer. That is 44.8% or 0.448 is the percentage reduction of the heat transfer when we introduce a shield in between the plates 1 and 2. Similarly, we will take one more problem on the concentric spheres. Here, two concentric spheres 20 meter and 30 meter in diameter are used to store liquid nitrogen at 120 Kelvin in a room at 300 Kelvin. The space between the spheres is made perfect vacuum. The surfaces are highly polished to attain an emissivity of 0.04. Find the rate of evaporation of liquid nitrogen per hour if the latent heat of nitrogen is 200 kilojoules per kg. Okay, in this problem there are two spheres, one is 20 meter and another one is 30 meter in diameter. These are used to store what? Liquid nitrogen. So liquid nitrogen at a temperature of 120 Kelvin in a room at 300 Kelvin. The space between the sphere is made perfect vacuum. So these are the two concentric spheres. One is inside and another one is outside. There are two concentric spheres. The inside sphere is having liquid nitrogen at 120 Kelvin and the room is having 300 Kelvin, so in between it is a perfect vacuum. So inside surface we can take it as 120 Kelvin, outside surface we can take it as 300, so in between there is a vacuum. The surfaces are highly polished to attain emissivity of 0.04. So these are the surfaces which are polished to lower the emissivity, so therefore 0.04 is the emissivity. Find the rate of evaporation of the liquid nitrogen per hour if the latent heat of nitrogen is 200 kilojoules per kg. Means if radiation heat transfer takes place from the outer sphere to the inner sphere towards the nitrogen, then liquid nitrogen will be heated up and it will evaporate. And the latent heat of the nitrogen is also given, that is 200 kilojoules of heat energy is there for per kg, that is latent heat of nitrogen. So in this case, in order to find the rate of evaporation, so first we need to find out what is the heat transfer from outside surface to the inside surface between two concentric spheres. Therefore Q is equal to sigma into A1 T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 divided by epsilon plus A1 by A2 into 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1. Now sigma is nothing but Stefan-Boltzmann constant. A1 is nothing but area of the sphere, that is 4 pi R1 square, into T1 to the power of 4, that is the temperature of the first sphere, and that is nothing but inside sphere, minus T2 to the power of 4, that is the temperature of the outside sphere, whole divided by again 1 by epsilon 1 plus R1 by R2 square. A1 by A2 is nothing but area ratios, so only 4 pi is constant, you can cancel. Therefore, R1, R2 is left out, R1 by R2 square into 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1. So here epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 both are same because they are highly polished with emissivity 0.04. Now substituting all these values, sigma 5.657 into 10 to the power of minus 8, 4 pi R1. See, diameter is 20 meter, means radius. R1 10 meter, half of the 20, into 120 minus 300, both are in Kelvin, directly we can substitute 120 to the power of 4 into 300 to the power of 4, whole divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1, 0.04, it is given, plus 10 by 15, that is R1 by R2, 20 by 2 is equal to 10 meter R1, 30 by 2 is equal to 15 meter R2, that is 10 by 15 square, into 1 divided by 0.04, again the inside surface of the outer sphere is also polished, therefore 0.04 with the emissivity, minus 1. So after that calculation we will get minus 15733.3 watts. So why will we get minus? Because heat is transferred from the outer wall to the inner wall. So here inside the concentric sphere is having lesser temperature, whereas the outside sphere is having the more temperature. Obviously heat will radiate from the outer concentric sphere to the inner concentric sphere, and therefore equation what we have written is from Q1 to 2. Q1 to 2 means inside to outside. So that obviously will come negative because heat is transferred from the outside sphere to the inside sphere. Now rate of evaporation can be calculated as Q divided by latent heat. So Q is nothing but 15733.3 divided by latent heat is 200 into 10 to the power of 3 joules per kg. Now this is in terms of watts. Watts is nothing but joules per second, and this is joules per kg. So joules per second divided by joules per kg will give you that kg per second. Therefore this ratio will give the answer of 0.078 kg per second. So joules in the numerator and denominator get cancels, and here in the numerator joules per second will be left out. Second is in the numerator, therefore it comes in the total as a numerator. Here kg, 1 over kg is there in the denominator, again in the denominator, once again it is in the denominator, therefore kg comes in the numerator, therefore 0.078 kg per second. So that is the rate of your evaporation, means almost 78 grams or 0.0878 kg of liquid nitrogen will evaporate per second, which is equal to 283.2 kilojoules per hour. For hourly basis when we calculate, this has to be multiplied with 3600, then we will get 283.2 kg of nitrogen per hour will be evaporated. Now at this point it is important to know some of the special properties of shape factor. So we already know that what is the shape factor. Shape factor is nothing but it is the ratio of radiation energy emitted from surface 1, let us say, towards the surface 2 and in the direction of surface 2 to that of total radiation emitted by the surface 1 is called as shape factor from 1 to 2. And here there are some properties, special properties of this shape factor. They are as listed as below. Now, it is possible to reduce the calculation of shape factor of some complex configurations by the decomposition of configuration into group of configurations for which the shape factor may be more readily evaluated. So here, instead of calculating the shape factor for some complex configurations, so we will decompose it, we will calculate individually the shape factors, and to that group of configurations, shape factor may be more readily evaluated. In that form, we will have some of the special equations which are already derived in this section. The shape factor is purely a function of geometrical parameter. So this is shape factor F is a pure geometric parameter. When two bodies are radiating energy with each other, the shape factor is given by this equation, that is A1 into shape factor 1 to 2. A1 is the surface area of body 1. Shape factor 1 to 2 represents body 1 radiates and 2 receives, is equal to A2 into F2 to 1. In this one, A2 is the area of the body and 2 to 1 indicates the shape factor where the 2 emits the energy and 1 receives. The shape factor of convex surface or flat surface enclosing the first is always unity. So the shape factor for a convex or flat surface is always unity. This is because all the radiation coming out from a convex surface is intercepted by the enclosing surface, but not vice versa. So in this case, all the radiation emitted by the convex surface is absorbed by the enclosing surface. Therefore, shape factor for convex as well as flat surface will always be unity. A concave surface has a shape factor with itself because the radiating energy coming out from one part of the surface is interrupted by another part on the same surface. See, when we use a concave surface, so at one end whatever the radiation comes out, that will be interrupted by another part of the same concave surface. The shape factor of the surface with respect to itself is denoted by F1 to 1. Now in this case, instead of F1 to 2, there is only one body we have considered, that is convex surface. Therefore, shape factor is denoted by F1 to 1. See, this F1 to 1 for a convex and flat surface. If a surface area A1 is completely enclosed by a second surface A2, and if A1 does not see itself, then F11 is equal to 0 and F12 is equal to 1. See, you can see that A1 is completely enclosed by the one more surface A2. And A1, if it doesn't see itself, means F11 is equal to 0, means all the radiated energy will be equal to 0. So the ratio of radiated energy towards the second surface to that of total radiation is 0. And F1 to 2 will be 1, means total energy radiated by this A1 is completely absorbed by A2. Then substituting the value of F1 to 2 is equal to 1 in the equation. So now F1 to 2 is 1 because you can see that total radiated energy by enclosed body to that of total energy is the same, therefore numerator and denominator in this case will be 1, therefore f 1 to 2 is equal to 1. This value when we substitute in the equation, what we will get? See, f 1 to 2 here, if I substitute as 1, then a 1 is equal to a 2 into f 2 to 1. Rearranging, f 2 to 1 will become a 1 by a 2, ratio of areas of a 1 and a 2. Radiant energy between coaxial cylinder bodies placed in enclosure sphere is kept in a room or a box are examples of this solution. So coaxial cylinder bodies placed in an enclosure sphere kept in a room or a box are the best examples for the above case. If surface are taking part in radiation heat transfer, then energy radiated by one is always intercepted by remaining, that is n minus 1 surface, and by the surface itself also. Therefore f 1 to 1 plus f 1 to 2 plus f 1 to 3 plus and so on f 1 to n is equal to 1. Similarly f 2 to 1 plus f 2 to 2 plus f 2 to 3 plus f 2 to 4 and so on up to f 2 to n will be equal to 1. Again, f n to 1 plus f n to 2 plus f n to 3 and f n to 4 up to f n to n is equal to 1. In addition to the above, the reciprocal relationship between the two surface also holds good, that is a 1 f 1 to 2 is equal to a 2 f 2 to 1. Or a 1 f 1 to 3 is equal to a 2 f 3 to 1. Means from shape factor from 1 to 3 is also equal to the shape factor for 3 to 1 and so on. The shape factor between surfaces a 1 and a 2 is equal to the sum of shape factors between the surface a 1 and the surface which makes the surface a 2. Now consider shape factor between the surfaces. Here you can see the body is A1, this one is A3, A4, together it is taken as A1. Now this is the A2, that is nothing but A3, it is the sum of A3, A4, A5, and this body we have considered as A1. This states that the amount of radiated energy by A1 and intercepted by A2, which is equal to the sum of radiated energy intercepted by areas A3, A4, A5 as shown in the figure 21b. See, this is the A1, it radiates the energy, it is intercepted by A2, which is the sum of A3, A4, A5. Now consider two surfaces A1, A2 are radiating heat to other as shown in the figure 21a. Let A1 be subdivided into A3 and A4. Now you can see this A1 is subdivided as A3 and A4. Then radial energy heat exchange between A1 and A2 is expressed as Q1 to 2 is equal to Q3 to 2 plus Q4 to 2. Now Q1 to 2 is nothing but the heat radiation from 1 to 2 is nothing but, which is also equal to Q3 to 2 plus Q4 to 2, because so this 3 and 4 are nothing but again A2, A2, surface area A2. So instead of writing A2 to 1, we can write Q3 to 2, Q4 to 2. Considering the surfaces black, since T3 is equal to T4 is equal to T1 and A3 is equal to A4 are subdivisions of A1, then we get A1 F1 to 2 is equal to A3 F3 to 2 plus A4 F4 to 2. The above expression shows that F2 to 1 is not equal to F3 to 2 plus F4 to 2. So the shape factor from 2 to 1 is not equal to shape factor for 3 to 2 and shape factor for 4 to 2. for radiant heat exchange from A2 to A1 divided into A3 and A4, one gets. So A2 into F2 to 1 is equal to A2 into F2 to 3 plus A2 into F2 to 4. Simplified this one, cancelling the A2 on all the sides. F2 to 1 is equal to F2 to 3 plus F2 to 4. If A2 is divided into A3, A4, A5 as shown in the figure B, 21B earlier, then shape factor relationship is given by F1 to 2 is equal to F1 to 3 plus F1 to 4 plus F1 to 5. This states that the amount of radiated energy by A1 and intercepted by A2 is equal to the sum of radiated energy intercepted by the area of A3, A4 and A5. So this is some of the special properties of the shape factor. In the next session, we'll discuss some more concepts of the shape factor, and also we'll solve some more problems on the radiation heat transfer, which involves the shape factor properties. So today I will wind up with this, and you can contact me for any clarifications or doubts on the phone numbers which I have displayed on the screen in the beginning of the session. Thank you very much.